monster you've become.
Thank you.
good.
Where'd you run off to?
This reminds me of those altars.
There is a similarity, yes. But this sanctum is much more ancient and serves a rather different purpose. The altars we came upon before were built to imprison the king. This, however, was built to provide the Cetra with a means to commune with them.
Commune with them? Why would the Cetra do that? The Gi were the enemy.
Would it be through friend and foe? Dichotomy is not set in stone, as mutable as the winds. But for now, Kanaki, let us concentrate on the matter at hand. Clearing a path to the truth.
Thank you.
What is it?
Their ire manifests once more. Do not underestimate this foe!
Talk about an axe to grind.
What else this thing missed at us? That's all! Bring it on!
Leave it to me!
Become quite the formidable fighter.
Sure have. So, does this mean I passed the test?
I'm afraid that decision is not mine alone to make. Let us consult with one more qualified. The Watcher of the Veil fought valiantly and offered up his life in defense of our home. As you see, he still watches over us to this very day.
Wait, is that Seto? My father? No, there's no way.
The poisoned arrows of the Gi transformed his body into stone, and there he has stood ever since, his watch eternal. Our savior.
What about my mom? Did she know what had happened to him?
Why, of course she did. It was, after all, she and Seto who asked me to seal off the cave.
But why? Why did she never tell me the truth?
Because she knew that if she did, you would attempt to seek your father out all by yourself. Your parents strove to keep our Veil safe. But there is one thing they fought even harder to protect. You, Nanaki, their son.
She was afraid because I was too small and weak.
Back then, perhaps, but not anymore, heavens no. You've become a fine warrior in your own right. And that is precisely why I brought you here. But this is not where your journey is meant to end, my dear boy. You must leave the Veil once more.
But I'm a Watcher now. I gotta protect our home like he did.
Listen to me, Nanaki. When I first heard your friend's emphatic warnings, I dismissed them outright. No more than the ravings of misguided youths. When you've lived as long as I have, you start to believe you've seen it all. That no surprises remain. But I realize now how very foolish I have been. The eyes that I thought saw the world clearly have grown blind to new possibilities.
But...
I would hate to impede your progress any further. I bid you leave, Nanaki, before, like me, you become inured to your own ignorance. With sharper eyes and keener ears, go forth and in my stead seek the great truths of our world! Look after him for me.
Don't worry. We will.
You failed this trial, my boy. Continue your training and try again. Are you up to the task, Nanaki?
You bet I am. After all... I am Nanaki, Watcher of Cosmo Canyon. And son of Seto, protector of our Vale!
My thanks, Seto. You are as magnanimous as ever. The warrior Nanaki, and you, the Cetra. Come with me.
An exciting turn of events indeed.
We'll back you up for 2,000.
No. This one's free.
We need to, you know, save our homeland.
How can you talk like that in a place like this? I'm scared out of my wits here.
I don't know. This Gi dude's too nice to freak me out.
He may act nice, but who knows what he's planning. Stay alert.
The home of the Gi lies beyond. Now let us begin our journey.
Not so fast. What's in it for us? Unless it's materia, you can count me out.
How strange you should mention materia. My people are also in search of it.
Okay, all aboard!
Would have stayed longer if I could, but I'll be back soon. I promise. Maybe try swaying with the rocking of the boat?
I wanna move less, not more.
Didn't seem to mind when you jumped aboard.
Well, only because he mentioned materia.
Be quiet. The planet is listening.
And what's wrong with that?
Anything that reaches the planet's ears, in due time, reaches those of the Cetra. Unfortunately, the Cetra are not a tolerant people.
Excuse me, am I intolerant too? I'm Cetra.
You are indeed one of them, by lineage alone. You know not of their history. That has been lost to time.
Their history?
Consider your ignorance a blessing. The Cetra's past is fraught with horror and sorrow.
So there I am, on the ground, bleeding out, watching everything go dark. Thinking, this is it. This is how it ends. Only, it isn't. Suddenly, the wind picks up out of nowhere. It tugs at me so hard, it feels like it's tearing my soul right out of my body. Next thing I know, I'm back in the orphanage. But nobody can tell me who found me or how I got there. It's a miracle.
Sounds like what happened to me. Whole freaking army unloading on my position. I'm feeling every single force. One minute, I'm outnumbered, and the next, I'm alone.
None of it makes any sense. I somehow managed to beat the odds and wake up here, alone. Why in the hell did fate pick me?
Can't think that way.
Can't not think that way. Their luck runs out, but mine doesn't. I'm the only one who gets a pass. And now that it's just me, what am I supposed to do? You know?
Yeah, I get it.
Hey, come with me.
Sure, but why?
I'll explain on the way.